Hello, this is Andy. In this guide I will show you how to play Sweden in Supremacy mode of Age of Empire 3. This guide, you can use this build order in 1v1 or in team games. So let's go. This strategy revolves around you making tops and get a massive boom and then spamming Carolines. So at the start of the game, you want to build, you want to gather all your resources and you want to build your top as fast as possible, and you want to build it near your gold mine. Also, you want to herd your hunt to your first torp, so that your torp can gather from the hunt too. Also, if there are trees around it, it is nice, but it's not so important. The gather rate on trees is very slow, so yeah, the important thing is that you are near the gold mine. So on this map, we have sheep. So if there are sheep on the map, you want to get as many as possible, because the sheep you can kill near your tops, and then your tops we gather them pretty fast. So that's a nice economic boost. For treasures, you want to focus on getting experience, and then food, and then wood. In this game, I only found wood treasures so far, so I found two, which is pretty nice, so I can build another top right away. But yeah, usually you want to favor XP and food. Usually you start with your three villagers. You always start with the three villagers, then blueberries. Then if you are getting rushed or if you're getting attacked, you get Engelsberg, so you get your coin economy out faster, and after that two cannons, and only after those two cannons you go for torps, 700 wood, 700 gold, or 600 wood, or musk HP, whatever you need. So the standard build, which I do in this video here, is three wilds, blueberries, four torps, Engelberg Ironworks, 700 wood, 600 wood, and then musketeer HP. Could also send 700 gold and go up faster. Usually you get your blueberries card during age up, and yeah, okay, so that's why you want to get an XP treasure, so you get the blueberries card faster. This will make your tops spawn blueberry bushes and double the gather rate, the food gather rate for tops from those blueberry bushes. So as you can see here, I found two goats, and you want to kill them near your tops, so they gather food there. So your edge up will be a little bit faster, because with sweets, your H2 edge up will be very slow, or very slow compared to other civilizations. So you want to had to accelerate that as much as possible. Usually you want to age up around 15 to 17 pop. So after I clicked up, I retask all my villagers to get wood. And if there would be a trade route on this map, I would take a trade post with the first 200 wood. But on this map there is no trade route, so I'm not going to do that, or I can't do that. Moment, I will just wait for my blueberries card, and then after it arrives, I will produce tops. Okay, so now, what you can see here is I sent my villager out. Hello. to the sides, and start building tops there. So yeah, in team games especially, you don't want to take your allies' gold. This one could maybe be okay, but yeah, usually you want to go to the sides and take gold there. So yeah, usually you want to wait until this arrives before you finish it, so I should have delayed it a bit, but doesn't matter too much, to be honest. So yeah. So for the moment I'm just building tops around gold mines and get up. So with the logistician we get an arsenal wagon and barracks wagon or military wagon. You can build barracks or stable or foundry, but we want to go Carolines only, so We are going to build a barracks. So, yeah, you want to send it forward for your mate. In 101 you want to build a barracks in your base because you're usually very late to H2 and yeah, it will, the risk is too big for this to get sniped, so you don't want to do that. My barracks is finished, I will switch my villagers from wood to food. Or usually when you age up you switch your villagers from wood to food, but not all. Usually I stick around with 6 on wood. And yeah, send 2 or 3 to gold for the meantime, so you can always get those batches of 5 carabines out. And yeah, but you only need, like as soon as you have the Engelsberg Ironworks, you don't need villagers and gold anymore. Then you have pretty much all on food. Okay, so my ally is being aggressive here with Janissaries and Abogans. And I'm going to support him with my Carolines. So also notice that that my rush isn't very good. So again, this build isn't designed to rush. This build is designed to boom and strong in colonial or commerce age, but not for rushing. So I will have enough units to support my ally, but I won't be the powers or like automate, for example. Also in team games, good allies are allies which are strong in the early game, so that would be, for example, Ottoman or Russian or even India, so you get your map control out early. So notice my Engelsberg's Ironworks arrived, and I have already sent a settler forward, and I need my second barracks now, so I can really start to spam my carabines. What I also did, I sent my top wagons to the side of the map, or usually you want to do them on the sides, but in this case I will send them even to the enemy side of the map, so because it is here is not a dangerous point, or it's not a contested point at the moment, so I can easily do that. So I have now 20 to 30 Carolines, and now is a good time to get the arsenal upgrades. Usually you want to get speed upgrade first, then in 101 you want to get the melee attack upgrade, so the bayonet upgrade for second. In team game it's usually not so important, or not that important, because you're not going to fight in melee that early, I would say. So the second upgrade in team games is usually for me the HP, then the melee attack, and then the second attack upgrade. And I will just here keep spamming on my double barracks Carolines with 26 villagers. Keep producing torps and keep producing Carolines, that's the name of the game, so yeah. At this moment their army is pretty strong, so my ally's army is basically dead, he doesn't have any Abogans left, he's producing some Hussars now. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to send my Carolines and flank my enemy. So soon I will have enough Carolines to 1 and 2 this army here. So sending his Hussar to stop me here, and now I'm going to engage with my Carolines. It's a bit unfortunate here because the wood here blocks my Carolines, so usually on an open field there more effective than this, so it's kind of not the best fight here. But as you can see, the army destroys Army of Yellow and delays these units would also kill this army here, but my ally arrives now with Hussars, so we win this fight anyway, so that's good. Now Swedes become really insane because I have I could have made all my tops if I microed better. So usually you have all your tops around 10 to 12 minutes. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to build tops, get my market and get the upgrades. So mainly the food upgrades, and keep spamming those carrots. Yeah, this would also be a good time to hit up. But, yeah. How do you fight with carolines? Basically, you use them in range mode for all units which carolines counter or are normal against. So that would be other musketeers or melee infantry or melee cavalry or even dragoons, so range cavalry. And the regular musketeer counter, so that would be longbowmen here, so bows, skirmishers, cannons, grenadiers, just go in melee mode, and they do decent against them in melee mode. So basically, units which should counter carolines, you go in melee mode, and normal units which are countered by carolines or are the musketeers, you stay in range mode. This would be now the time to go up, so I produce around 60 carolines at the moment. And if you want to go up, you can sell some food to get up faster. I think I'm getting now a third barracks. And I keep producing units. So keep in mind, I'm Swede and I'm playing against Brits. And Brits have among the best mid game in the game, so their boom is very strong too. But with this build, you will even outpace Britons, which we can see in a moment here, or which we already can see in the points here. Obviously, the Ottoman is falling behind because Ottoman have a very bad economy. Basically, I'm just getting my third barracks and produce carolines non-stop, get my upgrade. I will send also the platoon fire. If you, like in this case, I could have also sent my falconets here and my carolines, or my carolines if I needed more units, or yeah, even my mercenaries. But usually I will go, if I need units, I will go for these two cards. And if I have enough units, I go for platoon fire, which increases the attack of my carolines. And then for wood. Okay. Yeah, my mate is raiding here, which is pretty good. But here are two armies again. It's 20, 42 carolines against yeah, 30 infantry and 8 cavalry and 26 longbows. And let's see how the fight plays out. So, yeah, of course I have the flag advantage here, so my units have more upgrades and are a bit stronger, and my ally also has some units here. Has those Abu guns. And the fight is kind of close, but as soon as my other carolines pop and can directly engage in melee combat, it is kind of so I get my barracks up here again, just push this back and then. I mean, look at the resources. I produced all the time, and I still have almost 4k food. So, with a bit better macro, I could have had here like 30 more carolines on the field. So, that's how insane they are. Even with bad macro, will outpace everyone here. Okay, so, yeah, so. So because I have so much resources over, I will just go to industrial This will also be slowly the time when your torps will run out. Here's my first village, or my first coal mine is already depleted. You have to keep in mind that when 20 minutes hit, your economy will be significantly worse because all your torps run out of resources. So that's, you have to keep in mind that it will be weak. So at this point, this game is over because they have no map control. They run out of resources here. My ally raided some villagers here. Yeah. And my economy is still going strong. Theirs is decent, but it's not Sweden economy, so it's not broken, so. Yeah. Okay, so now I'm in industrial age. Because I have so many Carolines, I will send this card here, which gives my Carolines 25% more HP and make them ranged resistance. So this means they will take even less damage from longbows. I'm also getting the guard upgrade. So, what you can still see, even though I'm producing massive amounts of units, I still have so much food in the bank. Now, so we have here longbows, which are supposed to counter Carolines, but actually one, two, or one, two, three, so in this fight for maybe more longbows here, I lost four of my Carolines. And that's just insane. I mean, of course they are generic longbowmen, but they are still possible on my card, so. Let's watch post game. So how insane this economy is. So at first we want to see the villager population, as you can see. My villager population is just very generic. Like, I didn't do anything, I didn't only send 3 villagers, I didn't send any more or something. So even the Ottoman has more villager than I do. And yeah. Both of the Brits have an economy lead or a village lead of 10 to 20 consistent for the home pool game. Like in the end they have 20 more villagers. And let's look at all resources gathered now. My economy, all powered by the corpse, is just completely going to the moon like a rocket. So, like the top boom lets you power through the whole game. Oh. And that combined with the Caroline, which doesn't have a direct or a good hard counter, you would just roll over everybody. So maybe one more thing: if you are playing against Sweden in 1v1 or in team games, you want to hit them very early and stop the top boom from going up. So you want to, because I'm up very late. I have very few units at start, and with a good rush, you can kind of stop. The boom going off. Yeah, so this will be the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Have fun with this build, and I will see you around. If you have any questions, just ask them, and yeah, I will answer them.